BlocksCAD skills. Set operations. The difference block. Difference is a set operation. It works on two shapes together. To see how this operation works, let's bring out a sphere and a cube and render them. Notice that the two shapes overlap. Part of the cube occupies space that's inside of the area of the sphere. Now let's go to the Set Operations category and bring out a difference block. The difference block needs at least two shapes to be able to work. The first shape, the sphere, the one at the top of the block, is the primary part of the model we're going to preserve. The second shape, the cube, is going to be subtracted away from that first shape. Take a moment to think about what this might look like, subtracting the entire area of the cube from our model, including the part that overlaps with the sphere. Now render. You can see that we kept the sphere and subtracted the whole cube. Since part of the cube overlapped with the sphere, we can see the space made by subtracting that part of the cube. Let's reset our model by dragging out the cube and rendering, like this. Now, let's see what would happen if we switch the two shapes in the difference block. We'll put the cube in the first slot and the sphere in the second slot. And before we render, let's take a moment to think about what this new shape will look like. Okay, let's render. Now we have a cube with the sphere shape scooped out where the two shapes overlapped. What do you suppose would happen if we tried to take the difference of two shapes that don't overlap at all? First, let's reset our images like this. Then, to create a model without any overlapping areas, we'll need to get a translate block from the Transform tab and put it around one of our shapes, in this case, the sphere. Let's translate the sphere over so that it no longer overlaps with the cube. We'll start by moving or translating the sphere 20 millimeters along the x-axis to see if that gets us far enough away from the cube. Maybe a little more, 22 millimeters. That should do it. Now, what do you think will happen when we subtract the translated and non-overlapping sphere from the cube? Hit render, and you'll see that the sphere goes away, but because it wasn't touching the cube doesn't look any different because we subtracted zero area from the cube. Now, let's try subtracting a small sphere from a big sphere. You'll see we've already set this up with two spheres, one with a radius of 10 and one with a radius of 20. If we want to hollow out or carve out the small sphere from the larger one, we'll need to take the difference of the two, like this. Bring out a difference block, place the larger sphere in the top slot, the sphere we want to keep, and the smaller sphere, whose area we want to subtract, in the lower slot, and render. See any difference? Well, not yet. But if we zoom in, we can actually get inside the shell and see the cutout hole where the smaller sphere was. To make this even clearer, and to actually confirm that we did what we wanted to do, let's take a peek inside the larger sphere by using a cube to cut away part of the outer shell like this. Drag out a sphere, make it larger, 20 millimeters on the XYZ should work, render, and let's make sure it's poking out of the sphere, which we can see it is. Now, to subtract this area of the cube from the sphere, click the plus to add a new bay in the difference block, add the cube below the smaller sphere, and render. As you can see, the larger sphere now has two volumes subtracted from it, the cube and the smaller 10 millimeter sphere. This gives us a nice window inside of the sphere to confirm that it was carved out just the way we expected it to be. You can watch this skills video again, or, to practice what you've just learned, launch BlocksCAD and start building.